Creating SharePoint retention labels is an essential part of managing content lifecycle and compliance in your SharePoint environment. In this video, I'll show you how to create retention labels so you can do more with SharePoint. So let's begin. So first step would be to gain access in your SharePoint environment. So once you're in there, go to the MT65 Admin Center. And once you're in the Admin Center, go to the left-hand pane here, go to Admin Centers and Compliance. So once you press that, it will load and will redirect you to Microsoft Purview. And then once you're in Purview, you just go on the left-hand pane here again, and then we'll go to Records Management to create your retention labels. So in the records management dashboard, you can go to file plan and we'll go to create a label. So as you can see, we have labels here that was previously created. So we'll go create a label here. Then we can go create the retention label. So first name the retention label. Let's go sample cat label 2. Description for users and admins are important. So once you're done, we'll just go next. And then define your file plan for your label. You can go reference ID. It's always nice to have a reference ID. Business function or department, you can choose or create your own business function or department. So let's do that. You can add your own business function. In this scenario, since it's a sample label, I pre-created a sample label option. So I'll choose that and categorize it. It really depends on your own company's basically document management system rule. So just follow those rules in terms of categorization. In this scenario, we'll just go compliance for this particular label. So go choose that. And then you can define a subcategory or create a subcategory if you want to. FYI, if you create the subcategory, it takes a Microsoft minute until it shows up. So what I suggest is you get out of the kind of like retention label creation dashboard and then go back in. And if it's still not there, try again after 24 hours. Usually it will work. So I'll skip that. We'll go authority type. So we'll go regulatory. You can also create your authority if you want to. And same thing as provision or citation. You can create your own or you can go with the pre-created ones. In this scenario, it's a sample. So we'll just go with that provision. And we'll go next. So after you set your file plan descriptors, we will define the label settings. So you have three options here. First would be to retain items forever or a specific period. Enforce actions after a specific period. So what it would happen to that item after a specific period, or you can just label an item. For this tutorial, we'll go to the first option here. And then you can set, define the retention period. So let's go customize, and I'll go just 6 years and basically 6 months and 6 days. Let's do that. So you can define when the retention period will start. So I'll go when items were labeled. It's okay. So once you're happy, you just go next. And then choose what happens during the retention period. So you have two options here. Basically, you can edit, and if that item gets deleted, it will go to a secure location, which you can access later on, or you can just go use mark items as a record, so you cannot edit or users won't be able to edit or delete items. Only admins can execute on these particular items. So we'll choose the first one, we'll go next, and what happens after the retention period, you have these options here. We'll go delete items automatically, and then we'll go review. Description, name, description, reference IDs, and settings, and then we'll go create. So once you're successful, you can go with these three options here. You can publish this label right now. You can auto apply these labels on specific types of contents, or you can do nothing, publish later, or auto apply it later. What we'll do is we'll publish it right now, and just go that. We'll just press done. Choose labels to publish. This is what we'll publish. Just double check. Next, we'll add to the full directory. Basically, the scope, you can go adaptive or static. Adaptive is much more dynamic, and static is just like just basic. So we'll just go static for now. And you can publish it on all locations in your tenancy, or you can choose specific locations. In this scenario, I'll just publish it in SharePoint. So let's go, we'll turn those off. And then you can specify what sites you want to publish it on in SharePoint. But in this scenario, I'll publish it in all sites. And we'll go next, and then create your policy. Or name your policy sample. And then we'll just go next. And then just review. Everything good to go. And then just go submit. And then once you submit, you'll go into this page here. Your retention label was published, and you can do other actions if you want to. But in this scenario, I'll press done. And now, if we review, you'll see that here in our labels list here. So you can see that cat label 2, and these are the settings that we created: 6 years, 6 months, 6 days, auto delete, reference ID, and category. So that's it. You created and published your labels. So we can go test it now. So after you publish your label, it's now time to apply the labels. So in this scenario, I am on one of my SharePoint pages here, Operations Hub, and I will apply it on a library. So we'll go to the library I want to apply it to. Let's go documents. And then once your library loads, you can just go to the settings cog over here on the top right. We'll go library settings. And then we'll go more library settings. Once that loads, you can go apply labels to the items in this list or library. So we'll do that. And then you should be able to see the label that you created or published in this drop-down pane here. Our current label, the new label, is not loaded in the tenancy yet, because it usually takes like around 24 hours for it to show into the tenancy or into your SharePoint environment. So in this scenario, I will apply a pre-created label, which is sample cat record. So it's retained for 4 years instead of 6 years, 6 months, and 6 days. So pick that, apply a label to existing items in the library if you want to, but if you don't want to, then just go save. But I'll apply it, and then we'll just go save. And then once it's done, you'll be able to see the retention labels applied on every item in this library. So we'll check that. As you can see, where is it? Yep. The sample cat record is applied in this particular document or this particular item. So to recap, what you learned is how to create retention labels and apply it in your SharePoint library. And why it is important is because retention labels in SharePoint help you enforce data retention policies, manage content lifecycle, and maintain compliance with legal and regulatory requirements. It's important to regularly review and update your labels and ensure that they align with your organization's changing needs. So again, thanks for watching this video. This is Ed from Regroove. If you like it, please like and subscribe. Bye.